So we continue with personnel practices today. We were talking about recruitment. In fact, we had just started about talking about recruitment. Very important. The process of recruitment. What is the process of recruitment? We start off with job requisition. What does that mean? Different departments send their demands to a central agency that we require certain persons for these slots, for these kind of jobs. These are job requisitions. Along with the determination of qualifications and other conditions of recruitment policy, these are compiled together by the recruiting agency and an announcement of vacant posts is made, and the announcement mentions that this is going to be through a competitive open exam. Extremely important. The cornerstone of the merit system. You got to have open competitive exams, and the qualifications have to be clearly spelled out. Once this happens, people apply. And then, naturally, the applications have to be scrutinized. Ye dekhna hai kya sahi logon ne apply kiya hai, unki qualifications, unka residential status, unke dusre aspects, kya wo sab conditions fulfill honi. ये स्क्रूटनी आपने करनी है। स्क्रूटनी के बाद आ जाता है असल मसला कि आपने वो इम्तिहान कंडक्ट करना है। The open civil service exam has to be conducted. And we do know that a lot of students apply, a lot of candidates apply. तो ये एक बहुत बड़ी एक्सरसाइज होती है, छोटी एक्सरसाइज नहीं होती। जब फेडरल पब्लिक सर्विस कमीशन خاص طور پہ جو فیڈرل اوکیوپیشنل گروپس ہیں فیڈرلی کانسٹیوٹیڈ ہیں ان میں بہت لوگ اپلائے کرتے ہیں تو فیڈرل سرویس کمیشن کا ہی یہ سارا کام ہے ایڈورٹائز کرنا پاکستان میں اس کے بعد ایگزامز کو کنڈکٹ کرنا سٹوڈنٹس کو انوائٹ کرنا فور ایگزامز آفٹر سکروٹنی جو سوٹیبل پائے جائیں سو This is not a small exercise. Ab aapne exam kara diya. Ya a number of exams kara diya. Because generally, there will be a number of exams. After that, you are going to make a list of eligible candidates and send them to the competent authority. ये वर्ड बड़ा यूज़ होता है कॉम्पिटेंट अथॉरिटी क्या होती है कॉम्पिटेंट अथॉरिटी इन दिस केस कॉम्पिटेंट अथॉरिटी वो है जिसने आपको अपॉइंट करना है इन अकॉर्डेंस विद द रूल्स हर चीज़ की अपनी कॉम्पिटेंट अथॉरिटी होती है एक कॉम्पिटेंट अथॉरिटी वो है जो आपको छुट्टी दे सकती है एक कॉम्पिटेंट अथॉरिटी है जो आपके ऊपर डिसिप्लिन करते हुए एक किस्म की पेनल्टी डाल सकती है لیکن اس سے ہائر پینلٹی ڈالنے کے لیے پرہیپس ایک ڈیفرنٹ کمپیٹنٹ اتھارٹی ہو تو گویا اب آپ نے لسٹ سبمٹ کر دی کمپیٹنٹ اتھارٹی کو اس کے بعد سیلیکشن ہو گیا ایک خاص پروسس میں سے گزر کے فائنل سیلیکشن ہو گیا پبلک سرویس کمیشن جو کمپیٹنٹ اتھارٹی ہے ریکروٹ کرنے کی پاکستان میں اس نے ایک فائنل سیلیکشن کر لیا ناو one main part is over, then you get appointed. And after appointment, the role of the civil service of Pakistan in our country finishes. You go on probation. कुछ अरसे के लिए आप कंफर्म नहीं होते, आप अपने महकमे में जाकर जो आपको मिला है, जहां आप अपॉइंट हुए जाके काम करते हैं 6 महीना साल, वो ट्रायल है एक किस्म का, दे आर चेकिंग यू आउट, विल यू बी एबल टू मैनेज इट, इसको प्रोबेशन कहते हैं. इस दौरान आपकी सर्विसेज बर्खास्त भी की जा सकती हैं इफ़ यू आर नॉट फाउंड फिट. एंड आफ्टर प्रोबेशन, once you have completed successfully that probationary period, aapko place kiya jata hai ya aapki placement ki jati hai against a particular post in that particular department or that group of service. Uske baad aapki training start hoti hai, jisko aap orientation training bhi kehte hain. In other words, you are being acclimatized to the working of the department. एक अरसा आपको लगता है उसके लिए, इसको इन सर्विस ट्रेनिंग भी कहते हैं. यानी अगर आप पोस्टल सर्विस में गए हैं तो आपको बताया जा रहा है कि पोस्टल महकमा कैसे काम करता है, मुख्तलिफ लोगों की ड्यूटीज क्या है, ऑब्जेक्टिव्स क्या है ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के, उनको कैसे मीट किया जाता है, स्ट्रक्चर क्या ऑर्गेनाइजेशन का, किसकी क्या रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी है, वगैरह वगैरह. दो किस्म के मेथड्स हैं, एक डायरेक्ट रिक्रूटमेंट का और एक इनडायरेक्ट रिक्रूटमेंट का. डायरेक्ट रिक्रूटमेंट में वी फिल अप पोस्ट फ्रॉम द ओपन मार्केट. ओपन मार्केट का मतलब है पूरी कंट्री, द होल कंट्री इज द मार्केट. कोई मुल्तान से पढ़ा हुआ है, कोई रहीम यार खान से पढ़ा हुआ है, कोई क्वेटा से पढ़ा हुआ है, कोई खुजदार से पढ़ा हुआ है, कोई पिशावर से, कोई मस्तूंग से, पूरे कंट्री, नॉट जस्ट द अर्बन एरियाज, अंडर डेवलप्ड ऑल काइंड ऑफ एरियाज, दे आर द बेसिस ऑफ रिक्रूटमेंट, दे आर द पूल फ्रॉम विच वी आर गोइंग टू रिक्रूट. और इनडायरेक्ट रिक्रूटमेंट रिफर्स टू फिलिंग अप अ पोस्ट फ्रॉम कैंडिडेट्स ऑलरेडी इन सर्विस. दिस इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड इंटरनल रिक्रूटमेंट. एंड डायरेक्ट रिक्रूटमेंट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एक्सटर्नल रिक्रूटमेंट. सो यू आर रिक्रूटिंग पीपल हु आर ऑलरेडी वर्किंग इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन बट वाइंग फॉर हायर पोस्ट. सो you recruit them for a higher post generally. But the real thing we are talking about is the direct recruitment process. इसमें क्या होता है, इसके advantages क्या हैं? Provides equal opportunity. Exam वही होना है, qualifications वही हैं, चाहे आप underdeveloped area से हैं या developed area से हैं. So it is providing equal opportunity to all and sundry, irrespective of caste, religion or race, or where you hail from. In fact, underdeveloped areas have an additional quota of seats in various groups. So we are providing equal opportunity, and in a way more than equal opportunity. And the direct recruitment system will definitely attract capable and qualified persons from the universities, which are our major pool for recruitment. And if any aggressive search has to be employed for recruitment, it is the universities which have to be targeted. Now this method of recruitment, how does this recruitment help us? This direct method of recruitment, It infuses new blood and fresh outlook. Enhanced stagnation is neutralized. But the direct recruitment method has its demerits also. And those are that in the beginning you are recruiting non-experienced persons who have a long way to go before they really become experienced and real professionals in the field. Whereas you might have got specialists in the field from outside who already have experience, it would have been cheaper to have them. And hence there would have not have been a requirement of a prolonged training. Aapko bahut lambi aur comprehensive training deni padti hai all through the career of such civil servants jinko aap directly recruit karte. Aur isme ek aur jo negative baat hai wo ye hai ki jo log pehle lower post par kaam kar rahe hain aur expect kar rahe the ki wo promote honge lekin aapne us level par bajaye indirect promotion karne ke from within direct kar rahe hain logon ko bahar se recruit kar rahe hain to wo log jo pehle within the organization kaam kar rahe hain they feel bad about it and sometimes there is a certain quota fixed for employees who are within the organization but working at a lower level, lower post, to come and join the people who have been directly recruited. But generally, there still is bickering. Still there are complaints that the quota is not enough. And also in the long run, because you have to get promoted from one post to another, many a time. If you do not get promoted, you get demoralized. Even if you do not get promoted because of your own fault, still you get demoralized. This is human nature. Now, what qualifications are laid down or required for employees? The nature of qualifications for direct recruitment may include the citizenship or the civil status. Where do you belong? Are you from that country? Are you a born citizen? Are you a naturalized citizen? Are you just an alien? What is your civil status? What is your status in that country becomes very important. Because generally it is thought that people with other nationalities, if they come within the civil service of a particular country, they may work against the interests of that country. So there is always a citizenship qualification. And again, to narrow it down, you have the residence or the domicile qualification. We have the domicile qualification in Pakistan. As I said before, that persons originating from many places with different domiciles, that underdeveloped areas especially, do get special quotas and special treatment. The sex and age are other factors. In case of sex, some countries may have special quotas for females to improve the gender ratio in the administrative employees. Ages may vary from 18 to 25. Generally 18 to 25 18 to 28 or 18 to 45. 18 to 45 would refer generally to the US system where we have this position classification system for specialists. Educational qualifications, there has to be a minimum education qualification. Almost all countries have it except the US. Experience. You may or may not ask for experience because mostly it's young graduates from the university who give a hand, who try the civil service examination without experience. So in our case, experience is not necessary. Technical knowledge. Sometimes, especially in the position classification system, technical knowledge is required. आगे personal qualifications की बात हो रही है, यानी कि वो traits जो कि unfortunately हमारी civil services में कम से कमतर होते जा रहे हैं, like integrity, honesty, tact, faithfulness, the executive ability, energy to do work and all that. अब आप determine कैसे करेंगे कि किसकी क्या qualification है और किस हद तक वो qualified है? One way is that the appointing authority directly judges it. And that can be on the basis of interview or testimonies or qualifications and previous track record, experience, relevant experience. So the evaluation can be on the basis of qualifications, your track record and experience, or the more structured part, you can have a written examination. You can have certain ability tests. Your various abilities, like your management, your executive ability, can be checked. Your aptitude for a certain service can be checked. Will you make a good policeman? Do you have those traits or a personality required for a uniformed service or not? Achievement tests, how high you achieve certain scores, like the IQ level, for example. Other achievements, personality tests. Now, the traits come in which we had talked about. Do you have a positive attitude towards life, towards issues, towards problems? What kind of traits do you possess? What kind of a character do you have? Are you confused? Are you clear-headed? Do you have that streak of integrity and honesty? Performance tests. What's your efficiency? Are you good at problem solving? How can you perform under crisis? So these kind of tests will determine your performance. And of course, physical test is very straightforward. You take certain medical examinations or physical examinations and the doctor gives a report. Now the different systems of recruitment. The cadet system, perhaps one of the oldest ones. The recruitment is generally made at a young age, 16 se 20 saal ki umar mein. Aapne dekha hoga hamare yahan bhi military ke liye khas taur pe commissioned officers, junior commissioned officers ke liye cadet colleges available hain, jisme there is a long period of education or training. Now this kind of thing, this kind of arrangement is very popular for defense related jobs. Sometimes it's used for other services also, especially in Russia. It's been in vogue for many a service. Because as a cadet, at a young age, you start building up a mindset of the individual. And the process of developing the personality goes on, along with imparting of the educational qualifications. Then what is more relevant to us is the general mental ability system. In this case, you get a pool of people with very broad educational attainments and good mental abilities. They may be graduates in liberal arts, or science ke bhi graduates ho sakte hain, koi bhi background ho sakti hai, lekin well-rounded hain, exposed hain, broad educational base hai, jisse bahut si offshoots jab nikle to wo samajh jayenge cheezon ko, aur unka mental ability kafi hai. इस किस्म के सिस्टम में 21 प्लस के लोगों को हम लेके आते हैं और इसी कॉन्सेप्ट पे हमारी सिविल सर्विसेज पाकिस्तान की, इंडिया की, यूके की और कुछ यूरोपियन कंट्रीज की, खास तौर पे जहां जहां रैंक क्लासिफिकेशन सिस्टम अप्लाई करता है वहां पे ये कॉन्सेप्ट पॉपुलर है. जैसे हम अपने यहां देखते हैं दैट वी जस्ट नीड अ ग्रेजुएट इन सेकेंड क्लास इन एनी डिसिप्लिन व्हाट्सोएवर टू बी एलिजिबल फॉर टेकिंग द सेंट्रल द ओपन कंपेटिटिव एग्जाम फॉर द फेडरल सर्विसेज ऑफ पाकिस्तान. तो ये वही कॉन्सेप्ट है, वही फिलॉसफी है कि आप इतने बड़े पूल में से वो लोग जिन्होंने ग्रेजुएट किया है उनके कंपटीशन करा रहे हैं. उससे आपको पता लग जाएगा कि हाउ गुड दे आर एज फार एज द ओवरऑल जनरल एजुकेशन इज कंसर्न्ड एंड आल्सो देयर मेंटल एबिलिटीज. हैविंग लुक्ड एट द recruitment systems, now we go to the subject of training. How are we going to train these inducted young employees and turn them into great civil servants? Now, a rather old report, the Asseton report in the UK, which came out in 1944, talked about certain aspects of the training program and what it should aim at, what kind of a development in the personality and qualifications of a person should take place in the civil service. We need a training program which produces, according to the report, a civil servant who can transact business with precision and clarity. No ambiguity, confused nahi hona, clarity ke saath civil servant ko decision making karni chahiye, clarity ke saath objectives ko approach karna chahiye, no dilly dallying. Then it should attune the civil servant to the tasks he has to perform in a changing world. यहां फिर चेंज का कॉन्सेप्ट आ गया. बैक इन 1944 दे रियलाइज द चेंज द इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन रिलेटेड चेंज लेटर ऑन द पोस्ट वर्ल्ड वॉर चेंजेस देन द इकोनॉमिक बूम्स देन द क्राइसिस. And nowadays, the technological change. So, all these changes have to be appreciated by the civil servant to make the most of them and not let them have negative effect on the nation or the society. Another aspect was to make civil servants conscious to the danger of becoming mechanized robots. For God's sake, be human beings. not machines, the report said. हमें रोबोट्स नहीं चाहिए, हमें सिविल सर्वेंट्स चाहिए, मशीनें नहीं चाहिए, हमें वो लोग जिनका हार्ट हो, जिनका सोल हो, who are willing to serve, who are responsive, we need them. So it was expected that good training would impart this kind of emotional and very, very responsive attitudes in the civil servants. और आपने आगे चल के हायर वर्क करना है, हायर लेवल ऑफ वर्क करना है, उसके लिए भी आपको प्रिपेयर करना पड़ेगा. सो यू हैव टू मेक सिविल सर्वेंट्स, यू हैव टू डेवलप द कैपेसिटी इन देम फॉर दैट हायर लेवल ऑफ वर्क एंड रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज विच मे बी मोर डिफिकल्ट, मोर कॉम्प्लिकेटेड, मोर सोफिस्टिकेटेड एंड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. Somehow the training should be able to improve the morale, the integrity and service orientation of civil servants. Service orientation. Agar aapka morale high hai, acha hai, you have integrity. Service orientation will become, I'm sure. आपने serve करना है masses को, so you have to be public service oriented. Way back in 1944, they thought this was a problem, and even today this is a problem. Today, perhaps we need even more and more emphasis on the kind of training that can provide public service orientation in our country. और last but not least उन्होंने कहा कि ऐसी training provide की जाए जो कि vision और outlook civil servant का broaden कर दे, because it's a global village now, you are interacting with everyone all the time. और अगर आपका myopic viewpoint है, broad नहीं है, so the nation will suffer, the public will suffer, you will not be able to handle the problems which will be faced by the administrative system in such a time of change. Ab kitni kisam ki trainings hoti hain, ek main category banti hai pre entry training ki. Ye aap lower level civil servants ko bhi kara sakte hain जो आमतौर पे वोकेशनल स्किल्स में आते हैं. दिस कुड इंक्लूड द पर्सन हु इज मेंटेनिंग योर ऑफिस और इवन अ क्लर्क परहैप्स. प्री एंट्री ट्रेनिंग का एक और जो एस्पेक्ट है वो है ओरिएंटेशन ट्रेनिंग, यानी एक छोटी सी ट्रेनिंग जो आपको इंट्रोड्यूस कर देती है उन कॉन्सेप्ट से और एनवायरनमेंट से जिसमें आपने काम करना है. यानी अगर आपने डिस्ट्रिक्ट मैनेजमेंट में काम करना है तो एक छोटी सी ट्रेनिंग जो आपको बता दे कि डिस्ट्रिक्ट मैनेजमेंट क्या होता है, आपको पता लग जाए कि रेवेन्यू रिकॉर्ड क्या होता है, पटवारी, तहसीलदार, कानगो, इन सब का क्या काम है, डिस्ट्रिक्ट कलेक्टर का क्या काम है और क्या क्या रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज है, डेवलपमेंटल एस्पेक्ट्स क्या है, क्राइसिस आए तो वो कैसे मैनेज करना है, नेचुरल हैजर्ड्स को कैसे मैनेज करना है. और इंडक्शन ट्रेनिंग इससे जरा ज्यादा एक्सटेंसिव होती है, इसमें डिटेल लर्निंग आ जाती है about the basics of work to be done, which I mentioned before. कि अगर आप as a Pakistan administrative officer जा रहे हैं in the field, और आपकी फर्स्ट पोस्टिंग असिस्टेंट कमिश्नर या डीसीओ के दफ्तर में है, तो आपको पता होना चाहिए कि काम क्या क्या है, कुछ अंदाजा आपको होना चाहिए. सो दैट इज इंडक्शन ट्रेनिंग. दूसरी जो मेन कैटेगरी है वो है आप आ गए हैं सिविल सर्विस में, अपॉइंटमेंट हो गए, प्रोबेशन हो गए, कंफर्म हो गया. नाउ फ्रॉम यू विल हैव पोस्ट एंट्री ट्रेनिंग. ये आमतौर पे हमारे सेटअप में रैंक वाला जो सिस्टम है, रैंक क्लासिफिकेशन सिस्टम है, इट मे नॉट बी डायरेक्टली रिलेटेड टू द जॉब बट इट अटेम्प्ट्स टू ब्रॉडन द जनरल एबिलिटी ऑफ द एम्प्लॉई. यानी अगर आप ऑडिट सर्विस में या फाइनेंस सर्विस में, तो आपको अकाउंटिंग स्टैंडर्ड्स की लेटेस्ट वर्जन के बारे में ये नहीं होगी ट्रेनिंग, बल्कि ये मैक्रो हो सकती है. इट माइट टॉक अबाउट फाइनेंशियल क्राइसिस, इंटरनेशनल फाइनेंस क्राइसिस. इट माइट टॉक अबाउट द लेटेस्ट ट्रेंड्स इन डिस्पर्समेंट और अप्रूवल ऑफ डेवलपमेंट लोन्स बाय द वर्ल्ड बैंक. तो ये डायरेक्टली रिलेटेड नहीं है, लेकिन आपका जो पर्सपेक्टिव है अबाउट फाइनेंशियल मैनेजमेंट वो ब्रॉडन हो रहा है. इट मे बी अबाउट एनवायरमेंट फॉर दैट मैटर, कंसर्न्स एवरीवन. सो यू आर ब्रॉडनिंग द जनरल एबिलिटी ऑफ द एम्प्लॉयज टू एप्रिशिएट एंड टू इंटीग्रेट ऑल दीज थिंग्स व्हेन दे थिंक, एनालाइज एंड मेक डिसीजंस. अच्छा, इसमें शॉर्ट टर्म और लॉन्ग टर्म ट्रेनिंग भी हो सकते हैं. आमतौर पे शॉर्ट टर्म ट्रेनिंग उसको कहा जाता है जहां आप 2-4-6 हफ्ते के लिए बाहर जाते हो या दफ्तर में ही रहते हो और आपको एक ट्रेनिंग करा दी जाती है. लंबी ट्रेनिंग जो होती है, इट कैन बी फॉर अ नंबर ऑफ मंथ्स एंड मे बी अप टू 3 इयर्स. दिस में इवन इंक्लूड गेटिंग अ डिग्री फ्रॉम समवेयर. Then there is this concept of departmental training. कि आप department की working को और अच्छी तरह समझो. आप higher responsibilities के लिए तैयार हो जाओ, आपको पता लगे कि higher level पे क्या काम करना पड़ता है. तो इस किस्म का exposure देने के लिए within the department कुछ senior अफसरान हो सकते हैं, बाहर से भी आ सकते हैं लोग from related departments. So they train you and expose you to these aspects. इसमें आप skills और background training भी इसको इन trainings को कह सकते हैं, क्योंकि किसी हद तक आपको नई background दी जा रही है about things. और skill training program में क्या होता है? Employee is provided with knowledge of particular technique, method, rules, regulations, or background training jo hai wo general hai, wo socio economic, political or administrative aspects ke bare mein, yani environment ke bare mein agar koi training hogi to usko hum background training kahenge. अगर प्रेजेंट स्टेटस ऑफ द इकोनॉमी को डिस्कस कर रहे हैं ट्रेनिंग में, दैट इज अ बैकग्राउंड ट्रेनिंग. लेकिन अगर आपको रूल्स ऑफ बिजनेस ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट की ट्रेनिंग दी जा रही है, या आपको प्रोक्योरमेंट रूल्स की, आपने चीजें परचेज कैसे करनी है, क्या तरीकाकार है, कैसे एडवर्टाइज करना है, नहीं एडवर्टाइज करना है, किस अमाउंट तक, किस तरीके से आपने परचेज करना है, बिड प्रपोजल किस किस्म का प्रिपेयर कैसे एग्जामिन करना है, सिंगल बिड, सिंगल एनवलोप, डबल एनवलोप प्रोसीजर फॉलो करना है, ये परचेज ट्रेनिंग, ये प्रोक्योरमेंट ट्रेनिंग जो होगी, दैट वुड बी स्किल्स ट्रेनिंग. फिर फिर इन सर्विस ट्रेनिंग का जो कॉन्सेप्ट है उसमें कुछ किस्म की ट्रेनिंग्स आ जाती हैं. एक है वेस्ट्यूबल ट्रेनिंग. दिस इज जनरली अ शॉर्ट टर्म वन. आपको कुछ लेक्चर्स लिए जाते हैं, फिर आपको एक चक्कर लगवाया जाता है. यू गो टू डिफरेंट साइट्स टू एग्जामिन थिंग्स और गो टू डिफरेंट ऑफिसेस टू एग्जामिन थिंग्स. इंस्पेक्शन ट्रिप आप उसको कह सकते हैं. देन यू मेक योर रिपोर्ट्स एंड ऑल दैट. सो दिस इज समथिंग कॉल्ड वेस्ट्यूबल ट्रेनिंग. अ सर्कुलर ट्रेनिंग, इसमें यह है कि आपको कुछ अरसे के लिए उसी महकमे के जिससे आपका ताल्लुक है डिफरेंट विंग्स में काम करने दिया जाता है या अटैच कर दिया जाता है और कुछ असाइनमेंट्स दे दी जाती हैं, सो दैट यू अंडरस्टैंड फर्स्ट हैंड एंड बाय डूइंग इट द वर्किंग ऑफ दैट डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ योर्स. दिस इज कॉल्ड सर्कुलर ट्रेनिंग. एक और तरीका जो ट्रेनिंग का तरीका तो नहीं, नाम जो है रिफ्रेशर ट्रेनिंग. यानी आप कोई चीज जानते हैं, कोई काम कर रहे हैं, टेक्निक है, रूल्स है, प्रोसीजर्स है, स्टेग्नेशन आ जाती है काम करते करते. सो टू रिफ्रेश योर माइंड, टू अपडेट योर नॉलेज टू सम एक्सटेंट, बिकॉज कुछ ना कुछ तो नॉलेज का फर्क पड़ा होगा बाय देन, यू आर गिवन अ रिफ्रेशर ट्रेनिंग. फिर रीट्रेनिंग. इसमें दो किस्म की हो सकती हैं, या तो वही फील्ड जिसमें आप काम कर रहे हैं उसकी ट्रेनिंग, कोई नई चीज आ गई है वो, या जो आप पहले ही कर रहे हैं वो अच्छे तरीके से आप कैसे कर सकते हैं, रीट्रेन किया जा रहा, या इट मे बी इन अ न्यू फील्ड. वो कैसे, मे बी योर जॉब टाइप क्वालिटी कॉन्टेंट इज गोइंग टू चेंज. तो जब आपका जॉब कॉन्टेंट चेंज होगा, नेचर ऑफ योर जॉब माइट चेंज स्लाइटली ड्यू टू टेक्नोलॉजी और व्हाट्स एवर, सो यू डोंट वॉन्ट टू लूज योर जॉब, यू विल बी रीट्रेन फॉर दैट न्यू अपॉर्चुनिटी, बट इट इज अ सिमिलर काइंड ऑफ जॉब यू विल बी डूइंग. अब ट्रेनिंग टेक्निक्स क्या है, लेक्चर मेथड, वी ऑल नो अबाउट इट. जैसे यूनिवर्सिटी में पढ़ते हैं, उस्ताद आके लेक्चर दे देता है, कुछ लोग सोए हुए होते हैं, कुछ लोग मैसेजेस कर रहे होते हैं, कुछ लोग जोक कर रहे होते हैं, कुछ लोग स्माइल कर रहे होते हैं, शायद कुछ सुन भी रहे हो. सो दैट्स द लेक्चर मेथड, वेरी बोरिंग. सिंडिकेट मेथड, इसमें यू मेक ग्रुप्स, दैट्स कॉल्ड अ सिंडिकेट ऑन सम इशू. इट कुड बी एन इशू ऑफ नेशनल इंपॉर्टेंस. सो दे डू अ रिसर्च, कम अप विद अ कंक्लूजन और अ प्रेजेंटेशन एंड मेक अ प्रेजेंटेशन. दिस वुड जनरली बी अ स्मॉल साइज ग्रुप. इन फैक्ट दिस टाइप ऑफ ट्रेनिंग ओरिजिनेटेड इन द यूके एट देयर एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव स्टाफ कॉलेज ऑन हेनले वे बैक, and has since then been used by the administrative staff colleges in Pakistan and India to date. The case method, this is where a real life case which has been written down by a case writer is presented to you and you study it and then you critically analyze it, and then the group gets together and there is a prolonged discussion. Now to improve your decision making skills, there is this incidence methods training, which is similar to the case method somehow, but involves a lot of decision making. Role play. You are supposed to imagine, or you are put in a situation where you think that you are a particular officer or doing a particular kind of work. So how do you do it? And others would assess it. Your peers, the other officers attending the training, are supposed to assess how you played that role. It may not be a single role, it may be a role play of a number of people at the same time. This is interesting. It is creative. It can be creative. Again, management games improve your decision-making styles, and this is generally in the private sector, but also used in the public sector, where you have these situations coming up, where you have management problems, where the information can be limited. And then your decision-making styles and skills are tested and improved. And there is that group, the whole group, which is participating in the management game. By the whole group, I mean you subdivide the class into groups and they play management games. Sensitivity training, as the name suggests, it's got more to do with your attributes, your personal attributes, rather than the professional expertise. So this might aim at things like appreciating other people's problems, anger management, stress, dealing with stress, and stuff like that. Very important. We come now to the promotion part. The civil servant wants a promotion. That is why I joined the civil service. So what is promotion? Promotion refers to the movement of one employee from current position to a higher one. Simple. आप इस वक्त 17 ग्रेड में हो, आप 18 में जाना चाहते हो, फिर आप 19 से 20 में जाना चाहते हो, and so on. Or, very important, a badly designed promotion system can harm an organization. It can ruin an organization, I would say. इतनी bickering हो जाएगी, इतनी frustration हो जाएगी, that the objectives shall not be met. You will never be able to serve the public. Even in the private sector, a successful organization always has a very well-designed promotion system. Now, what are the components of a promotion system? It might involve a change of position, where you leave one position and move on to another higher one. A change of duties or work. You may be assigned high level duties or a different nature of work, which is supposed to be more difficult. Change of responsibility. You are expected to become more responsible. And you feel, yeah, I've been entrusted with additional responsibilities. Or the level of responsibility may go up. Change of title. पहले आपको डिप्टी सेक्रेटरी कहते थे, अब आपको जॉइंट सेक्रेटरी कह रहे हैं. पहले आपको असिस्टेंट डायरेक्टर कहते थे, अब आपको एडिशनल डायरेक्टर कह रहे हैं. पहले आपको डायरेक्टर कहते थे, अब आपको डायरेक्टर जनरल कह रहे हैं. सो चेंज ऑफ टाइटल, चेंज ऑफ पे, नेचुरली जब आप हायर लेवल पे जाएंगे, प्रमोशन होगी, तो कुछ ना कुछ पे तो इंक्रीज होगी, होनी चाहिए. Then the promotion, very important, sometimes we overlook this, from lower to higher grade, class or service. This could happen within the same organization. Or you may go to another organization. For example, you might come to a high level with change of service. You might come from the provincial service in Pakistan to the federal service in Pakistan. There is a quota. So this would constitute promotion. Now, what are the principles of promotion? These include the seniority principle. Seniority refers to duration of service. The employees with longer duration of service gets promoted. Very simple. अगर आपकी 10 साल सर्विस है, दूसरे की 9 साल है, पहले आप प्रमोट होंगे. सीनियोरिटी प्रिंसिपल. आपके बाल ज्यादा सफेद हो गए या आपके बाल ज्यादा गिर गए, यू सीनियर. सो इफ आई हैव पुट इन more years at a particular post than if you have worked for lesser years, I shall, should, and will be promoted. This is the principle of seniority. Merit principle is not all that straightforward, although something that this is where what makes the difference between efficient and inefficient organization. If a merit principle is being followed, the organization is going to be definitely more efficient. And what is that? This implies promotion of the most meritorious employee. Merit may be determined by, number one, personal judgment of the head, by a promotional examination, or by an efficiency rating system, which means that there are set procedures for testing your efficiency vis-a-vis promotion. Or you may be given an examination, again, a set procedure. And then not that scientific a procedure, personal judgment of the head of the department where you're working, or your supervisor, or the competent authority. And then the third merit, since both the above merits, both the above systems have the merits and demerits, the third merit captures, tries to capture both together. Seniority cum merit, which we call seniority cum fitness in Pakistan. This principle provides that promotions be determined on the basis of length of service as well as qualifications and achievement of the employees. So you will also keep, give a weightage to the seniority and a weightage to how you perform, to your efficiency, to achievement when you are being considered for promotion. What are the essentials of sound promotion practices? Number one, adoption of standard specifications pertaining to duties, qualifications for all promotions in the government. That's clear. You should know exactly the requirements for promotion vis-a-vis duties, qualifications, etc., length of service. Classification of positions into distinct classes, grades and services. There should be a classification of positions. That this is grade 17, this is grade 18, this is grade 20. And who can be promoted to what? The higher administrative positions should be included, because that is where bickering can be. If the highest administrator comes from outside, the morale of the whole organization may go down. Adoption of principle of recruitment from within. This is what I've said before, because that will foster motivation It will motivate people to work harder so that they can head the organization. Adoption of principle of merit in determining promotions. हमने seniority की बात की, merit की भी बात की, merit कम fitness या merit कम seniority की बात की, seniority कम fitness की बात की. Sound promotion practice में ये ख्याल किया जाता है, it is the merit which counts. Promotion should be on the basis of merit. और फिर आप determine कैसे करेंगे कि ये चार पांच आठ लोग promotion deserve कर रहे हैं, इनमें से who is the best? There should be a system for determining whether it be the merit system, but then the merit system has to be very very systematically based. Let us have a look at the systems of recruitment in vogue. There are two main systems, the expertise system and the lateral entry system. Under the expertise system, the government recruits persons with specific qualifications and technical expertise in which a long range of age can be accommodated, from 18 to 45 years. This facilitates mobility between government and private sector. But this is quite popular in USA, as we said. But it cannot meet the requirements or the compulsions of the career civil service system, which is prevalent in our country and many others, including the UK and India. So expertise system, or which is based on position classification, is one system which is quite popular. And as opposed to this expertise system, we have a lateral entry system. In this, a certain percentage of recruitment as senior civil servants is made externally through competitive selection without affecting promotion chances of insiders. So we had the merit system, we have the expertise system, and then we have the lateral entry system. In the lateral entry system, kuch log 5-10% civil service ki strength ke aap induct karte hain as senior civil servants, senior levels par, lekin competitive imtihan lekar. Aur ye khyal rakhte hue ki jo log pehle hi kaam kar rahe hain us adare mein and are looking forward to promotion, unke chances jo hain bahut zyada negatively na impact ho. Otherwise ye counterproductive ho jayega, wo log kaam karna kam kar denge, morale gir jayega, bickering shuru ho jayegi. Hamare yahan bhi ye system practice hua hai Bhutto regime mein, way back in the early 70s. But unfortunately, proper competitive selection nahi hoti, koi structural, koi structure nahi banaya jata, koi design nahi system kiya jata competitive selection ka in our country when lateral entries are made. And most of the time, lateral entries do produce bickering amongst the regular civil servants. So this the merit of this system is that you are bringing in fresh blood, new expertise, perhaps very very technical people, very knowledgeable about the changes in technology into the system. So while practicing the system, you have to be very careful to balance the pros and cons of the system. So as usual, we will summarize all the discussion we had in today's lesson. We talked about recruitment systems in detail because the quality of the human resource, we said, is what makes or breaks an organization. And in this case, the administrative system on which the whole country depends. There are two types of training. We looked at direct and indirect. Two types of recruitment systems we looked at, direct and indirect. Direct being more important because that is when you are taking fresh graduates from a big pool of population, the whole country, through a competitive exam to man posts in the administrative system. Whereas in the indirect method of recruitment, it is from within that lower level employees are being promoted to higher levels where they have to deal with higher responsibilities and duties. We saw that the direct merit system of recruitment provided a lot of advantages, and that countries had evolved sound policies to implement them. Right from the beginning, when you are calling for applications, on to the various tests, written and oral and others, followed by selection and communication to oppose to the various department, after communication opposed by the various departments, and then the competent authority preparing a list of the eligible candidates who then get appointed on probation, and on confirmation of probation they get the permanent appointment. We also saw that training was a very important component of the human resource setup in the public sector. Because for promotion to higher post, trainings nowadays are a must. Trainings can be of many types. The pre-service training which you take before service, for certain posts that can be an induction training or an orientation training which acquaint you with the environment of the job or the department you are going into. The induction training goes a little further than the orientation training by including familiarization with actual working of the department. In case of in-service training, it is generally of a much higher and generalized nature, exposing you to the latest technologies or the socio-economic aspects and environmental aspects. However, these in-service trainings may also be skills or jobs or practice or rules oriented, especially in case of retraining, where the nature of the job you are expected to hold may have changed substantially, or the job you are working at needs that your skills be refreshed in a newer mode, such trainings are quite common. Then there are trainings for much higher posts which you may hold, like the trainings carried out by the Pakistan Administrative Staff College or the National Institutes of Public Administration, which incorporate methods like case studies, management games, which hone your skills of decision making and also upgrade your overall knowledge. These trainings, these in-service trainings are essential to ensure that the quality of the human resource in the administrative system is becoming superior as it moves up the hierarchical ladder. We also know that promotions play an important part in the administrative setup, and every civil servant is looking towards promotions because that is essential part of your career development. And some authorities feel that it is the promotion system, the soundness of the promotion system, which makes or breaks an organization, because it can breed demotivation, stagnation, bickering, infighting, jealousy. Under such conditions, we saw that there are certain sound principles which have to be followed while designing a promotion system. And administering a promotion system is not easy either. Promotion can be based either on the judgment of the superior officer or a number of evaluation and tests. But whatever the practice, it should be transparent and very well documented, because no one in this process should feel that they have been left out, not properly, not given a proper chance, or due to political or personal favoritism, they have been overlooked. If this happens, then the fate of the whole organization is in the balance. So, proper recruitment, multifarious training, and a good, sound, transparent to all system of promotion are the vital factors in the success of any administrative organization. Thank you very much.